Welcome to Cinemeric Live, Application Technology Made Easy. The aim of this series of short videos is to present specific topics on the practical use of Cinemeric. Now we come to the fifth part of our special video series all about flexible CNC programming. In our last video, we looked at control structures. Our topic for today is subprogram techniques for flexible CNC programming. When working with subprograms, I again advise you to use a digital twin of the CNC. As already mentioned, for this purpose, I use Run My Virtual Machine, the virtual Cinemeric One. It enables you to create cycles for your own machining tasks and test them safely on the PC before going to the machine. First of all, there's some general information on using subprograms in Cinemeric, and then, in the second part, I'll be covering how you can create your own user cycles. Why do we use subprograms, and what advantages does this give us? After all, you could also code the production order linearly in just one CNC program. So, why would you write subprograms or your own user cycles? The reason is that using subprograms makes for clearer, more easily readable programs, which also require less storage space. And another big advantage of user cycles is that you can access already tested, parameterizable program sections. So let's take a closer look at the nesting structure. The maximum nesting depth of Cinemeric subprograms is 17. With the top level, this means that Cinemeric can manage a total of 18 program levels. Let's start from the main program at the top level, where we call our first subprogram. From this subprogram, we can call another subprogram, and so on. In this way, it's possible to call a total of 12 subprograms. Up to 3 additional program levels are then provided for Cinemeric technology cycles available for call-up. And a further 2 levels are reserved for interrupt routines. These can be used by tool breakage systems, for example. As you can see, there are more than enough program levels available to the user for even the most complex production orders. But where can we put our subprograms to store them, and where can we actually find them? Let's take a look at the search sequence and access rights. First, the subprogram searches in the folder of the calling main program, and then in the collective folder for main programs. Then it continues in the folder for subprograms, and then in the folder for user cycles. You could store your subprogram in these folders. The next folder in the sequence is for manufacturer cycles. However, the machine user cannot access this folder, so we can't put the subprogram in there. We can't put it in the last folder in the sequence, the folder for standard cycles, either, because only Cinemeric itself has access rights here. Moreover, the CNC interpreter never searches in adjacent workpiece folders. If the subprogram is located in another workpiece folder, the path to it must be specified explicitly. Simply select the workpiece folder and subprogram in the CNC editor under Various, Subprogram, and confirm with OK. The subprogram call is now in the program with its path. There are several ways of creating a subprogram call. You can simply write the name of the subprogram into a CNC block in the main program, and then the CNC interpreter will call our subprogram. Or you can use the CNC language command call with the name of the subprogram in quote marks. This is also how subprograms are called in adjacent workpiece folders, by the way. If we want to call the subprograms indirectly in flexible CNC programs, we simply define a string variable, assign the text to it, and use the call command with the variable, and we're done. another tip on handling CNC programs in Cinemeric. Cinemeric traditionally makes a distinction between the main programs with the ending MPF and the sub-programs with the ending SPF. However, this is only a superficial differentiation. Cinemeric itself treats MPF and SPF as completely identical. It makes no difference whether you call an SPF in the MPF or an MPF in the SPF. It's also no longer necessary to distinguish between M30 and M17 at the end of the program. An MPF can end with M17 and an SPF can end with M30. So much for the classic sub-programs. Now let's talk about the user cycles. The first question is, what is a cycle exactly? Let's first consider a classic sub-program. In simple terms, these are external program sequences with a name by which they can be called. For cycles, the principle is the same, except that parameters can also be transferred in the call. For example, when a drilling cycle is called, the drilling depth can be transferred directly in the call. So, a cycle is actually nothing more than a subprogram with parameter transfer. This makes handling cycles more flexible, and they do not have to be constantly adapted. The program code of these tested program sequences does not therefore have to be accessible to everyone in the program manager. User cycles are not found in the conventional storage structure for CNC programs. That's why we switch to the commissioning operating area, enter the password customer, and then switch to the system data input screen. From here, we navigate via the NC data folder to cycles, and then to user cycles, and then press new to assign a name. When assigning the name, it's essential to avoid giving the same name to the cycles of the machine manufacturer and the Cinemeric cycles. If names are identical, it doesn't cause an error message, but the CNC interpreter will stop searching as soon as it's found its own cycle with the same name. This effectively deactivates the Siemens and the manufacturer cycles, which is not what we want. The user cycle is already open in the CNC editor. The first command in our cycle is PROC, which stands for procedure. The command is followed by the name, in this case, my drill cycle. And this is exactly the name by which the cycle is called. Unlike normal subprograms, the cycles do not respond to file name, but the text that follows the PROC language command. In this special case, the file name and this text happen to be the same. The next step is to specify the transfer parameters. The cycle expects two floating point numbers here. One parameter within the cycle responds to the name depth, and the other to the name infeed. These variables, therefore, do not have to be explicitly defined with def. Now, we add an important command, save. Save ensures that the modal G-code groups of the calling program are saved. For example, if we were to switch over to incremental dimension, G91, this would ensure that the absolute dimension is restored on returning to the main program. Otherwise, collisions might occur. The next command, single block off, suppresses single block processing. Single block run in is not necessary because cycles have usually been tested. With display off, which is the last command in this line, the current block display is suppressed. Here too, the reason is that it's irrelevant to display the inner workings of tested cycles. For the rest of the cycle, the complete familiar Cinemeric CNC command set is available. Incidentally, the cycle is not completed with M30 or M17, but with RET. This restores the modal G-codes of the calling program, which were previously saved with save, on returning to the main program. However, if anything has been modified in the transfer parameters, that is, in the PROC line, a CNC reset is required. This is because Cinemeric only initializes the parameter interface of the cycles after a power on, Modifications within a cycle, on the other hand, always take effect immediately and do not require a reset. To call the cycle in the main program, we now simply specify the name. The values for the two transfer parameters are in parentheses. In our example, these were 200 mm for depth and 5 for infeed. Variables can also be entered instead of constants. If nothing is specified, Cinemeric always sets the values to default. In our example, that would be 0 for both depth and infeed. So, that's all on today's topic, sub-program techniques for flexible CNC programming. I've now explained all the theoretical basics of flexible programming. In the following videos, I'll be presenting more interesting CNC language commands. So, stay tuned. And don't forget the CNC for You newsletter, of course. It contains all the latest news and interesting facts about using Cinemeric. That's it for today. Thank you for watching and see you next time.